The History of Bitcoin. Hey guys, we are going to be looking at how Bitcoin came to be. But before that, I would like to ask you how your experience with Bitcoin has been. Have you made money investing in the cryptocurrency market? Be sure to stick around to the end of this video as we look at how this cryptocurrency revolutionized the global markets. The Bitcoin story starts in 2008 with an anonymous founder called Satoshi Nakamoto. During this time, Nakamoto shared a post titled Bitcoin P2P eCash Paper. The message also gave a link to Bitcoin white paper called Bitcoin, a peer-to-peer electronic cash system. The actual name Bitcoin.org was registered on 18th of August 2008. Up to now, the identity of Nakamoto is still unknown, with many speculations being raised as to his or her identity. Some people even speculate that Nakamoto could be a group of people due to the complexity of the coding for Bitcoin. But more on this later in the video. For you to understand Bitcoin's rise in market value, it is key to understand how cryptocurrencies work. Bitcoin is a decentralized digital currency that operates without a central administrator, like a central bank. The process of creating Bitcoins is called mining. Transactions in the system are verified through network nodes and recorded through a public distributed ledger that we call the blockchain. You can exchange your Bitcoins for other products, currencies, and services. Unlocking Bitcoin value. The first blockchain for Bitcoin was mined in January 2, 2009, and it was called the Genesis block. At this point, Bitcoins had very little monetary value, and the coins were mainly available to miners. History states that the first transaction with Bitcoins took place a year later, when a man in Florida negotiated to purchase two Papa John's pizzas valued at $25 in exchange for his 10,000 Bitcoins. This was in May 22, 2010. Doing your math, this sets the cost of a Bitcoin at the same time at around 4 Bitcoins for a penny. However, if you could translate the momentary worth of those Bitcoins in today's exchange, the transaction was probably worth more than $114 million. That even sounds bizarre. $114 million for pizza. But Bitcoin's value had yet to be uncovered at this time. Before Nakamoto handed over the network alert key to Gavin Anderson, it is estimated that he had mined about 1 million Bitcoins. From the table, you see that Bitcoin price was largely flat between 2013 to 2016 when it spiked to an unprecedented levels in 2017. From there, most of Bitcoin value has been unlocked on various forums online and in the black market. The price at this point was largely arbitrary. One such black market was called Silk Road, where a total of 9.9 million Bitcoins were transacted with a total market value of $214 million. In February 2011, the price of Bitcoins reached $1, and by June of the same year, it had reached $31 before slipping back to single-digit numbers. By April 2013, the price of Bitcoin had reached $200, and by the end of the year, it was around $1,000. The price kept growing to reach a high of $10,000 in November of 2017. All of a sudden, interest in Bitcoins reached a peak, and hedge funds, to your next-door neighbor, were looking for a way to cash in. The prices took a downturn in 2018, only for it to rise again in subsequent years. One of the best years for Bitcoin was 2017, when the share price rose very high, only for it to drop again. This has created worries of price volatility. Bitcoin controversies. While Bitcoin has risen over the years in price, it has been plagued with a lot of controversies. When Bitcoin was launched, it caught the attention of the wrong kind of people: drug dealers and the black market. For them, the cryptocurrency was heaven sent, as they could bypass strict scrutiny from authorities as they traded. Dealing with drugs could be done anonymously online without attracting the attention of authorities. Up until 2013, the crypto was mainly used in the black market more than it was used for legitimate purposes. Things, however, took a turn when more people started embracing the coins as a medium of exchange. At around 2014, the main Bitcoin exchange, Mt. Gox, was forced to close down under a string of accusations of hacks and loss of Bitcoins. In 2013, the site actually went offline due to extended media coverage that brought in lots of traffic. The second most popular exchange at that time, Trade Hill, also in 2013, went down, further shuttering investor confidence. The final nail for Mt. Gox came in February 2014, when Mt. Gox was hacked into and 850 Bitcoins stolen. the company later filed for bankruptcy. The other opposition against Bitcoins comes from the government, who were used to exercising some form of control over the financial markets. How the money market works is that the governments print money depending on the size of their economies and monies available for circulation. Bitcoin posed challenges because they are decentralized and takes power from centralized money institutions like central banks. Some countries have actually banned the use of Bitcoins in their economy as they consider it to be a threat, while some have embraced it. Governments have also contended with the legal structure needed to sustain cryptocurrencies. It is still hard to qualify Bitcoins as a digital collectible asset or virtual currency. This also poses questions on taxation. Can you tax it? For example, countries like Israel and the US classify Bitcoin as a commodity and therefore tax it, while in European countries like UK, Russia, and the EU, they treat it as a virtual currency. What is the future of Bitcoins? Will it continue rising? This is the question at the heart of anyone who is thinking of investing in Bitcoins and other cryptocurrencies. When Bitcoin hit an all-time high of $19,783 in December 2017, many people, professionals and amateurs, joined the market. The price would later fall, causing some to abandon their investments in cryptocurrencies. The coin was very volatile, losing up to 25% of its value in a single day. At some point in 2018, it was valued at $4,000. Today, the crypto has recovered most of its lost value. But the question is, how stable is the cryptocurrency market? Faith in the market has been boosted by the entry of institutional investors. Since mainly Bitcoin was not considered as a worthwhile investment, many see their entry into the market as a vote of confidence. Large hedge funds and publicly traded companies have been bullish about the cryptocurrency. Also, some investors like PayPal and Square have joined the market, further boosting its credibility. The COVID-19 epidemic has also caused some institutional investors to take a closer look at Bitcoin, as many people shun using physical money due to the risk of transmitting the virus. From the graph, you note that Bitcoins have been very volatile. However, investments by institutional investors will play a big role in stabilizing the price. In the future, another factor that is going to keep Bitcoins bullish is the supply part. You see, there is a limited amount of Bitcoins in the market. While Bitcoins are actually mined, very few people are doing that at the moment. Institutional investors understand this and have been holding up many Bitcoins with the hope that once demand grows to a certain level, they can cash in big. The other big possibility that people are banking on is that at some time, Bitcoins are going to be floated on the NASDAQ. This will further boost credibility for blockchain assets. Some have suggested that what cryptocurrencies need is a verified EFT, exchange-traded funds. This will make it easier for people to invest in the market. But a lot of education is needed so that the general public understands how blockchain technology works. Many people are investing in the technology due to rumors of them making a killing. A Harvard professor by the name of Kenneth Rogoff estimates that the market capitalization for cryptocurrencies could hit a high of $5 to $10 trillion in the next 5 years. With this in view, it is estimated that the long-term values for Bitcoins could be in the range of $100,000. However, this is speculative and a lot can change in between. Do you think a time will come when Bitcoins will be formally accepted globally as medium of exchange? Which do you think has more potential, Bitcoins or Ethereum? Also, if you enjoyed this video, give us a thumbs up and subscribe. See you in the next video.